prior to configuring the transmitter, it is absolutely necessary that we know the maximum flow rate to be measured and the differential pressure produced by the primary element at that flow rate. In the following demonstration, the maximum flow rate will be 500 gallons per minute with a corresponding differential pressure of 150 inches of water. The transmitter configuration procedure is as follows.
Once the Trex communicator is connected to the communication terminals of the transmitter, press the on button, which is located on the left side of the Trex communicator. It's an orange button. Press it, hold it, you'll see the display flash, and the communicator will start to boot up. This will take several seconds. Once the communicator has finished initializing, you'll come to the home screen. From the home menu, select Field Communicator. The Trex communicator will then attempt to communicate with the transmitter. If the proper DD has been installed in the Trex, it will communicate and establish communication automatically with the device. Once communication is established, you will go to the online menu, and from the online menu, select device setup. From the device setup menu, select basic configuration. From the basic configuration menu, select PV unit. You'll get a warning that comes up telling you that the changing the PV units basically will be sent to the transmitter before any other changes can be made. Simply say OK to this message and then select the required PV unit for the application. This is the differential pressure PV unit. In our example, it will be inches of water. So we scroll until we see inches of water is highlighted, press the check mark, then press OK, and we will be routed back to the basic configuration menu. Now, from the basic configuration menu, select PV re-range, and at the PV re-range menu, select Edit LRV and URV. From the LRV and URV menu, select PV LRV. Now in this application, our PV LRV is zero. It's already set to zero. I don't need to change it, but I'm going to do it just to show you how it's done. So I press zero, press OK. And once that's done, I'll be routed back to the Edit LRV and URV menu. From that menu, I'm going to select PV URV. In this example, our upper range differential pressure at maximum flow is 150 inches of water. So I will enter 1, 5, 0 and press OK. The Trex will then return to the Edit LRV and URV menu. At this menu, press OK. And the Trex will return to the PV Rearrange menu. At the PV Rearrange menu, press the back button. And it will return to the Basic Configuration menu. From the Basic Configuration menu, select the back button again, and you will be sent to the Device Setup menu. From the Device Setup menu, select Full Configuration. From the Full Configuration menu, select Edit Parameters. And from the Edit Parameters menu, we want to select SV Units. So we will need to scroll down until we see that on the display. And there we have it, SV Unit. Again, you'll get the same message that this will be sent to the transmitter before any other changes. Simply say OK. When the SV unit selection comes up, we want to make it the same as the PV units that we entered previous, which were inches of water. And then press OK. And you will be returned to the Edit Parameters menu. Now, from the Edit Parameters menu, we want to select PV Exfer Function, or PV Transfer Function. There it is there. It's set to linear right now. Again, I get the same warning. Simply say OK. And I'm going to see a list of all the available PV transfer functions or PV modes. For this flow application, I want to select square root less than 1% cutoff on the DP. Press OK. And that will be sent down to the transmitter, and the Trex will return to the Edit Parameters screen. From the Edit Parameters screen, I'm now going to select PV Unit. And you'll notice that because we changed the transfer function from linear to square root, these PV units automatically changed from inches of water to percent flow. So I'm going to select PV Unit, say OK to the warning, and then I'm going to select the required flow units for my application, which is gallons per minute, and pick OK. Once I do that, I'll be routed back to the Edit Parameters screen. Now I want to select PV Flow URV. And in here, I'm going to enter my flow upper range value, which is, in this example is 500 gallons per minute. Press OK. And you will see that that has been sent down to the transmitter. That will put us back to, well, actually, it hasn't been sent. You see a little pencil here. The next step is to send it down to the transmitter. So I'm going to press the send button. And the Trex will now indicate the PV, URV in inches of water, and the corresponding flow rate. When you see this, press send. And the Trex will return to the Edit Parameters menu. From the Edit Parameters menu, select the Menu button in the lower left-hand corner. And then select Disconnect from the transmitter. You will be asked if you want to connect to another device or go to offline configuration or simulate. At this point, we don't want to choose any. We're going to press exit. It's going to say, are you sure you want to exit? Yes, I am. Which will bring you back to the home menu. At this point, you press the on-off button, which is the orange button on the side. And you're going to be asked, what would you like to do? Cancel, suspend, or turn off? I want to turn off. And the Trex will turn off automatically, at which point you can disconnect the Trex from the transmitter, and the transmitter is ready to be put into service.